Learning in the next generation HyperMesh can now be done right inside the application. After launching HyperMesh, a Getting Started dialog appears that contains a few short videos to get you started, links to documentation and self-paced training, and a handy list of keyboard shortcuts and mouse controls. Use the search tool if you need help finding or navigating to new and old tools in HyperMesh. The search tool also searches panels and keywords for each solver interface. If you're in a familiar panel, check the lower right of the application to see if there's a link to a new tool. Clicking on the link will navigate you directly to the new tool. Finally, all new tools in HyperMesh have workflow help designed to guide you through the workflow. Expanding the workflow help shows more information about the tool and some handy shortcuts. Click on the video link to see a quick animation of how to use the tool. We have new mouse controls in the next generation HyperMesh. To rotate the model, drag with the middle mouse button. The center of rotation is dynamic and is set depending on where you start rotating. To set it yourself, hold Ctrl and middle click. And to clear it, hold Ctrl and middle click in space or fit the model with the F key. To pan the model, drag with the right mouse button, and zooming is done with a scroll wheel. Alternative mouse controls are available and configurable in Preferences. All selection is now done with the left mouse button. Click to select, hold Shift to deselect. Notice the entity selector shows what's selected. This is where all the filtering and advanced selection is done, and is common to all tools. The browser also highlights your selection and is synced with the graphics. To clear selection, click in space or use the reset button in the entity selector. Window selection is done by dragging the left mouse button, and to pen selection, hold Ctrl, clicking or dragging. Right-click brings up a context menu depending on what you've selected. Common items include showing and hiding, advanced selection, the selection window toolbar, and editing. Double-click to quickly edit. All tools are located in the ribbon. Click on a tool to enter it, and click again or press Escape to leave the tool. The tools with blue labels are new and have new workflows. The other tools in the ribbon point to items we brought over from HyperWorks Desktop, including some panels. Next generation HyperWorks offers access to the same powerful 2D meshing technology found in the AutoMesh panel. This is available via Mesh Ribbon 2D Mesh Group. Meshing tools are organized based on engineering tasks such as Batch Mesher, CFD 2D Meshing, Panel Meshing, Rigid Body Meshing, and General 2D Meshing. This allows for simplified and streamlined workflows. Each tool exposes only the relevant options that are necessary for that workflow, with others set as default behind the scenes. Options are available via the Options menu under each tool, and less frequent options are available under Preferences in the Meshing tab. The General 2D Meshing tool provides options to choose different mesh types such as AutoDecide, Free, Mapped, QI Optimize, and Advanced, which gives access to the full suite of options available for customization. Here's a demo using General 2D Mesh with the mesh type set to Mapped. Once relevant meshing options have been defined, entities may be selected using the Entity Selector, right-click context menu, or keyboard shortcuts such as Ctrl-A to select all displayed surfaces. After the mesh is generated, access to the Density, Biasing, and Face Edit tools becomes available. Clicking on any of the mesh edge posts a micro dialog where you may specify a density value or element size, or click to increase or decrease the densities of the selected edges. In this case, a map mesh was selected, so linked edges are automatically updated simultaneously. Workflow help is available, which indicates the mouse controls and keyboard modifiers that may be used. A video is also available that shows how the workflow may be completed. The next generation HyperWorks has new tools for creating and editing geometry. Here's a quick overview of some of them. The Points and Lines tools allow you to sketch in 3D space and have very similar mouse controls. To create points, midpoints, and points at arc centers, use the Points tool. Click anywhere to create a point. Double-click to edit. To create midpoints, drag with the mouse. You can also hold Shift while dragging to lock the direction. This works the same in other tools like lines or split. To create a point at the arc center, hold Ctrl and pick three locations. Remember to check the workflow help while exploring the rest of the 3D sketching tools. To create surfaces, use the patch tool. Here you can drag between any two lines to quickly create a surface, or select any number of lines that define a new surface's boundary. Click the lines again to confirm, or use the middle mouse button. Clicking on existing surfaces lets you quickly delete them, and clicking on a surface that's just been created lets you toggle its tangency. You can also use the guide bar to find closed edge loops and quickly patch them. With the Extend tool, you can extend surfaces while automatically trimming across obstacles. And if you extend using the mid-surface inside a solid, it will automatically trim with the solid boundaries. To edit the connectivity and topology of surface edges and vertices, use the Stitch tool. Select surfaces to stitch together all the edges and vertices that are within the specified tolerance. Stitch individual edges by clicking them or dragging them to another edge. Stitch vertices together by selecting them or dragging them to another vertex. And finally, unstitch by holding Shift and selecting edges or vertices. We have some common pieces across many of the tools on the next generation HyperWorks. You'll see the Move tool for translating and rotating, or the Vector tool for defining a vector or plane orientation. To use the Move tool, grab any arrow or plane to move in that direction. You can type specific values or drag and snap with the mouse. If you need to ignore snaps for a bit, hold the Alt key. You can also grab an arrow tip to rotate freely about the origin, or grab the origin itself to move in 3D space. When clicking the origin, you can also realign the tool quickly using these buttons. To reposition the tool at any time, hold Shift or double-click it. The Move tool turns orange when repositioning. This lets you move the tool around without affecting your model. For example, if you need to change the center of rotation or choose a specific origin for translation. While repositioning, you can also toggle the Align to Park button to automatically realign the tool as you move around your model. To use the Vector tool, grab any handle to reorient it. Grabbing the arrow handle lets you define a vector between any two locations, and grabbing the plane handles lets you define a plane using any three locations. Grabbing the base handle moves the origin without affecting the current orientation. To align the vector tool quickly, hold Ctrl and click on any two locations to define a vector, or any three locations to define a plane. Clicking any handle lets you edit its coordinates, and use these buttons to flip direction quickly, translate and rotate your vector using specific values, input vector components, and orient to your camera view, normal or parallel. View and visualization modes of the model are controlled with the View toolbar in the lower left. To control the display of the model, enter the Show Hide tool. Immediately, you're placed in hide mode, so click anywhere in the model. This will hide what you picked and keep it selected. Keep hiding until you have the portion of the model you want. Middle click isolates to bring it back. More display control is available through the menu and the micro dialog. To save a view, click on the camera in the View toolbar. Type in a name in order to save it. At any time outside the Views tool, quickly save a view by pressing Ctrl and any number on the keypad. Recall previously saved views with just the number keys. All the visualization options for geometry and mesh are listed in their respective menus. And the model color modes are controlled here. Keep it in automatic to have the tools and selection filters control the color modes. All the standard views are listed in the model orientation menu. And the button to fit toggles between fitting what's selected and fitting the entire model. Finally, to get a look inside the model, use the Section Cuts tool. Click on the plus to create a section cut, and the micro dialog exposes section cut options, including the Move tool. Right-click to edit saved section cuts. FreeMesh morphing in the the next generation HyperWorks is available using the Morph Mesh tool, located in the Mesh ribbon. To morph any mesh, enter the tool and pick the nodes you want to move. You can pick nodes individually or hit the space bar to access advanced selection options. As you pick nodes, notice the low-lighted elements indicating the morph area and anchors that are automatically determined by default. When ready, use the Move tool to morph by either dragging with the mouse or typing specific values. While moving, elements in the morph area can stretch and compress between the moving and anchored nodes. If you need to reposition the tool, hold Shift or double-click it. The Move tool turns orange when repositioning. For full control over the anchors and morph area, at any time toggle the automatic checkbox in the guide bar and click the respective selectors to adjust them manually. Notice every selection change triggers an automatic remorph by default. This is an option and can be disabled in the guide bar options menu. Instead of moving nodes in space, you can also morph by mapping to a target geometry or mesh. To do so, use the optional target selector in the guide bar. You can map to target surfaces, lines, and even other meshes. As soon as you select targets, the Move tool is replaced by a micro dialog with mapping controls. When ready, click the Morph button. While targets are selected, you can still move nodes using this button, which will let you morph interactively while still mapped to the active targets. If you want to move freely again, deselect the targets at any time. When you're done, save your results into a shape that will let you revert and reapply it whenever you want. With the original magnitude, or even scale to any factor. Or, if you plan to keep your morphed mesh, feel free to remesh it using the Rebuild tool. With robust mesh rebuilding, you won't have to worry about mesh quality during morphing. Finally, as with any tool in the next generation HyperWorks, make sure to always check the dynamic workflow help for usage tips and available controls. Thank you.